Hello, Cancer. Welcome to February 2016. This is Gwendolyn of Readings by Gwendolyn, and welcome to the channel, or welcome back if you're returning. This video will be a taroscope for February 2016 for Cancer. So I'm just going to shuffle these cards here, and we'll get right into the taroscope. Oh, we got a bunch of cards that are wanting to come out right here. So let's see what those are, and then we'll see what else is going on for Cancer. Middle of the month, you've got the Sun card. That's one of the major arcana cards that is a really positive card. You've also got a lot of another one of the signs had this, and I can't remember who, but you've got a lot of cards with yellow imagery in their background, yellow backgrounds. Here's another one, both of these. So February may be a pretty sunny month for you. Usually yellows signify optimism, the golden rays of the sun, good things happening. So it's seeming like February may be a fairly sunny month for you, Cancer. At the beginning of the month, you have Emperor and you have Seven of Swords. Seven of Swords is a risk taker. This is someone who tries to get away with something. You can see in the imagery he's stealing five swords away, and he's trying to do it undercover without anyone seeing him, and he's kind of just concerned about covering his own bases, making sure that he's got his, and, you know, kind of cutting corners can sometimes represent criminal behavior. And this guy, the Emperor, is the person who is in charge. He is the one who enforces all the rules and makes all the rules. He's actually looking straight at this guy. So he's noticing what's happening. He's aware of what's happening. So if you or anyone else is trying to cut corners or taking risks, be aware that whoever's in authority or in charge is seeing all of that. You're not actually undercover, or the person who thinks they're getting away with something is actually not undercover. So that's what the month opens with for you, Cancer. Be careful that you don't try to get away with something, because those who are have the authority are totally aware of what's happening. And if this is you, Cancer, if you're in the position of authority, you're well aware of those who are trying to do something that's a little bit underhanded. Also in the beginning of the month, there may be something that happens that is tragic that you have, or that changes things dramatically. That's what this Tower card is. Tower card is when lightning bolts hit, come out of nowhere, and there's a lot of sudden change. And this card, Five of Cups, means sorrow or grieving. You can see that these three cups are spilled in the foreground, but there's two standing behind here, so not all is lost. If there's something that is causing you grief at the beginning of February, Cancer, just know that not all is lost. That's what this card tells you, even though you may have a reason to be sorrowful or grieving. Whatever happens, you may not see it coming. It may come out of nowhere, or this may be sorrow that you're having at the beginning of February for something that happened in the past unexpectedly. But know that even though the old structures are crumbling from this tower shock and sudden change, there still is a new day, but you kind of have to turn around behind you to receive the love that's still available to you. If you're preoccupied with what currently is, or what used to be, or what was, if you're focused on that loss, you're going to miss out on the love that's available to you in present time. So that's something to know for the beginning of February for Cancer. Other than that, this all, in some ways, one other thing I'll say is that this card, Ten of Swords, is an end to a certain way of thinking. You may be resistant against it because these are both in the reverse position. That shows some resistance to what's happening. And in this one, if you hold on to the same way of thinking, you're not going to be able to survive that way. It will consistently challenge you to the point, it'll drain your energy to the point where you won't be able to function. So Ten of Swords is the completion of one cycle and the beginning of a new. So the sooner that you can let go any negative thinking about whatever dramatic sudden change happens at the beginning of February or prior to this that you may be mourning over, it's going to serve you to let go any negative thoughts about that, because it's all it does is stop you in your tracks. All it does is make you not able to function. It's kind of, it's actually, this is a card where negative thoughts, all these swords represent thoughts. It's the mental air element, and it represents that these just take you under. So, in counterpoint to that, the rest of the middle of the month for you looks really good. You have the Sun card, which is very positive. This card is a card of acceptance. It's a card of self-love. It's a card of radiance and vitality. It means integrating different parts of yourself. When you're able to accept both your conscious positive qualities along with your shadow self, that realization and that enlightenment is what the Sun card is about. So it may mean that after you've been doing some grieving and there's this sudden dramatic change, that you're able to come to a point of acceptance and enlightenment and realization, and therefore, you know, the Sun shines down on you. That's the middle of the month for you, Cancer, so that's good news. Also in the middle of the month, you have a face-off between these two characters, the Knight of Coins and the Nine of Wands. Both of these are survivors. Both of these are warriors. Neither of them give up too easily. This one, Knight of Coins, is very steadfast. He's very pragmatic. He's always considering the bottom line before he makes any moves. And Nine of Wands, this character, you know, even if he keeps getting knocked down, he gets back up. He's a survivor, and he just, he's pretty relentless. I call this card my Cool Hand Luke card sometimes, because it keeps getting knocked down and it keeps getting back up. So there may be a face-off that you witness between these two characters. I almost get the sense like these two could be fighting over you. This is Knight of Coins, so this is more than likely a earth sign, such as Virgo, Taurus, or Capricorn, because the coins usually represent the earth element. And then Nine of Wands can be any sign, really, but it is a fire, it is wand, so it is fire energy, so that's more than likely a fire sign, so Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. You may have these two fighting, or they may just be friends of yours, people you know. They could be fighting over you, though, is the sense I'm getting in the middle of the month. Or they're competing for your attention, possibly. But that's what's going on in the middle of the month. But you're kind of sitting in a pretty area, just being aware of that and realizing that, and you're actually in a pretty good place of self-love. So that's going to put you in a good position regardless of what's going on. And it is fairly sunny, so I'm getting the sense that this could be, you know, friendly competition. It's not exactly like people are out to really get one another. This could be a friendly rivalry. But they're both good competitors. So whatever's going on, it's mostly your struggles with accepting and not just being swallowed by any grief, sorrow, or heartbreak, or negative thinking about something that changes dramatically at the beginning of the month, or something that you may still be thinking about at the beginning of the month. Towards the end of the month, Cancer, you have this Ten of Coins means an inheritance or receiving a sum of money. It means money accumulated over time from good decisions that have been made. And I'm seeing that you're not receiving as much as you had hoped to. That's this Ten of Coins in the reverse position. In the upright position, it basically means inheritance, a windfall of money, money you weren't expecting, or money that's been saved up and now you have access to it. Because it's in the reverse position, it's telling me that there may be some way in which this, whatever competition went on here, your negative thinking about it didn't bring you the results and rewards that you were hoping for, or as much as you were hoping for. And this King of Wands may have something to do with that. This is usually a fire sign. So this is Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius, and they don't necessarily have your best interests in mind towards the end of the month. There is a way in which they are kind of spinning a tall tale for you,
Or this is a card, Seven of Cups, of fantasies and desires, things that you may have choices about, but often see all this hazy, foggy, Neptunian energy that surrounds it. It's often a card of what you see is not what you get. So be very careful about taking or receiving something that your heart wants, but that doesn't actually end up being what you thought it was. It's very likely in relation to this King of Wands character, whoever that might be, again, fire sign, Leo, Sagittarius, or Aries, because they may be telling you some tall tales, or they may be telling you what you want to hear, but I would question the truth of what they're telling you when this card comes up, or question what it is that, what choices you're making. Make sure you look them really dead in the eye and do some research, because this card often, when we choose one of these cups, it ends up not being what we thought it was. So I'm seeing some things at the end of the month with these cards. There may be a little bit of deception that cuts you out of something that you were expecting to receive. And this could also be related to a relationship where you thought you were going to be behind closed doors, safe and sound, and in your castle, and just enjoying life as a couple. But in the reverse position, it's saying maybe it's not quite what you thought. And a lot of that has to do with this King of Rods person. At the end of the month, if you feel stripped of everything, don't lose hope. This card, Five of Coins, means financial loss, generally. But another meaning of this card is to not focus solely on the physical. This is a card of choice of focus, of whether we're going to focus on how much we feel like we lack in the physical world or material world, and realize that we have a lot of riches available to us in the spiritual world. You can see in this card that this person who is injured and who is a beggar, and in some decks he's out in the snow, is being comforted by someone who's in some sort of religious garb. They're in front of looks like a church or a mosque or some sort of religious window, a cathedral perhaps, and there's a glowing light that's coming from within there. So one of the things, if you do feel like through the trauma of what happens here and feel like you've bottomed out, which is another meaning of this Ten of Swords card, remember that you always have a choice of focus. Are you going to choose to feel like the victim, like the beggar, like someone who's injured, powerless, and cut off? Or are you going to realize that there's always a spiritual world that we can connect to and feel replenished and satisfied and full and connected to? So that's my reading for you, Cancer, for February. I would say just keep your eyes open, because there's a couple things going on that kind of point to choices that you're going to make, or things you might expect but that you're not going to receive, or watching what's going on with this, whether you relate to this character or this character, this person knows what's going on. And then in the middle of the month, enjoy this sunny energy. It's kind of an interplay, interesting. There's a lot of yellow cards. There are a few dark cards here. So see if you can, this is an interesting card to end on, because it is sort of being in a dark, cut off place or feeling like you don't have anything. But once you open up and realize that you do, you can be spiritually full at any moment, and that's where true richness and true values are. There's a lot of comfort there. So that's my reading for February for you, Cancer. Hope you enjoyed it. And I've got a special going on in February for relationship readings. I'll tell you a little bit about it in this next little segment. Thanks for watching. Yours in the stars. Hello, my stargazers. This is Gwendolyn. Thanks so much for watching. I want to say, in celebration of the love month of February, I'm going to be offering a 20% discount off my relationship readings for the month of February. So if any of you are interested in booking one of those, I'll be putting a link in the cards up above that you can click on, and it'll take you to that link. So it'll be 20% off for relationship readings for the month of February, just as a thank you to all of you. And again, just thanks for watching. Yours in the stars. check out my other videos for the other signs, and feel free to like, share, or subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. Yours in the Stars.